Mailbag, mailbag, mailbag. It's time to celebrate rampant consumerism with cheap crap from China. Let's see what I got this time. All right, from Singapore, which I suppose, depending on who you ask, is China. Gift value 5.00 times 1 to the power of, I can't read that, 0.4 grams, it says. Yeah, more than that. Yeah. Okay. There. What have we here? Oh, cool. These are ultrasonic range-finding modules. Those are neat. I was thinking of doing some kind of a robot or semi-autonomous remote control vehicle or something. And yeah, those will come in handy for that.
Two pieces, HCSR04 Arduino ultrasonic module, distance measuring transducer sensor, new. From GC Supermarket, seller that I bought lots of stuff from in the past, and several things this time. Yeah. $2.26 free shipping for the pair of them. Looks like I got a not too bad deal for them. Selling for $1.37 each these days, that's not too bad.
Oh, it's multiple things in here. What else we got in here? Let's get rid of this bubble pack. So, two of these, which are USB 3 volts, 5 volts, DTR, RXI, TXO, ground. Aha. That looks like a USB to, well, a USB to serial interface, what for using with Arduinos that don't have their own, similar to this guy here, only in micro S or micro USB rather than USB type A.
125 pieces. I bought two micro USB UART TTL module, 6-pin serial converter, new CP2102, which is the chip that it's using. I said I bought two, and they came for $4.63 again from GC Supermarket with free shipping.
Okay, and coincidentally, these look a lot like focus. These look a lot like Arduino Pro Minis, which is exactly what they are. ATmega 328P, but no USB on board. So you basically connect to program it. You connect this guy, transmit to receive, receive to transmit. 5 volts to 5 volts, ground to ground. And do we use DTR? I think so, yeah. Yeah, DTR to DTR, I think. In normal serial, DTR means data terminal reset or data terminal ready. On these, let me just take a look, see this one here. DTR is red, and yeah, it goes to DTR. So, okay.
Also from GC Supermarket, 125/10 pieces, new Pro Mini ATmega 328 board, 5 volt, 16 meg Arduino compatible nano. Don't say nano, it's not a nano. I bought two of them, and the pair of them cost $4.56 Canadian, with the usual free shipping. I don't know why I keep saying that, because I never intentionally buy things that don't have free shipping. Weird descriptions down here, and not much more information to be had. It's just a standard Pro Mini.
All right, next thing in, electronic parts, USD $0.01, 1 penny. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, this is a bunch more of those surface mount to dip adapters so that you can use surface mount components on a breadboard. Just like that 16-pin one, what I was playing with not that long ago. Okay, except for these ones are 8-pin.
20 pieces SOP 8, SO 8, SOIC 8 to DIP 8 interposer board. Good word, interposer board, PCB board adapter plate. Adapter is what I would have called it, but I don't speak translated Chinese. So this one was from Alice, 110-1983. Cost $1.28 Canadian for the 20 of them, or 99 American pennies if that's the language you speak.
Alrighty, next thing in. It is, gotta see this. Description of contents, love. Isn't that nice? $10 worth of love from China. Wonder how much love you get for $10. Oh. Okay, let's crack that open. Because that looks familiar. So this is pretty much exactly the same as these guys. And for these ones, I've just got the data coming from here to the first one. Data in, chip select, clock. And then the power is just jumping on the back using the power rails. So that comes in here, out there, in the bottom of this one. And had I soldered on pins there, I could add this one on here by going out of there and into the bottom of this guy. Or I suppose I could park it over here. And then all I'd have to do is go into the code and tell it that I have more columns to play with. I might do that, although that board's a little bit full. I don't really need that. I don't usually take USB power out of there. And this guy came with a bunch of DuPont wires, too.
So, the MAX 7219 dot matrix display. I couldn't find the actual listing for this, so I guess the seller's not selling these anymore, and it's been so long since I ordered it, back in July. But, anyway, here's my my purchase history. So $1.84, I'm 99% sure I bought this as an auction, because I've never heard of this seller before, 9.76091, but here it is, MAX 7219 dot matrix 8x8, $1.84, free shipping.
All right, next up is electronic parts. Looks like one each of four different things. So let's jump in here and see what this collection of stuff is. Oh, much stuff. Excellent. Okay. Nothing else in the bag. Okay. Now what's in the horribly crushed? Wow. Okay, it says electronic brick tilt sensor switch brick. Wow, that's nasty. I hope I didn't give them a good rating for packaging. Yeesh. Okay. What do we got here? Okay. GVNS, ground voltage and sense, I guess. There's also a 4-pin ground voltage N and sense. Okay. Okay, I don't know if you can hear that or not. Hang on, let me put it up by the camera. Don't know if you can hear that rattling around or not, but inside that little cylinder, sounds like there's just a loose metal bead which makes contact with the contact pins. We grab a meter here. There we go. So between ground and the sense pin, if I tilt it that way, it's an open. If I tilt it that way, it's closed. But hang on then. What happens if I go between the voltage and the sense pin? No, okay. So it's just a single pole, single throw switch. But, and it's just a little mechanical tilt switch. Okay.
Electronic brick tilt sensor switch module, 3-pin, 4-pin, angle sensor module for Arduino. Now that's the part that tricked me into buying it, is when it says angle sensor. It's not really an angle sensor. It's just a binary output. Anyways, it's 80 cents, $1.03 Canadian, from Alice 110 1983. I should have looked closer, but for that price, it's not a big waste of money.
Okay, what else we got here? Let me zoom out so you can see what I'm doing. Okay. So it came with one set of double row header pins, one set of single row header pins. And it calls itself a CJMCU-2317. Let me zoom in and see if I can read the chip. Okay, MCP23S17. And not much else on the board. Capacitor, couple resistors, and a little 6-pin 103. Is that a, that's an 8-pin. Is that a resistor array, possibly? 10K resistor array? Not sure. Oh, what's in the back here? That looks an awful lot like a microprocessor or a microcontroller, doesn't it? 3 analog. Oh, bunch of analog. And serial. Oh, is that an analog to digital converter? Okay, I need to do more research.
All right, let's check the data sheet on this guy. The MCP2317 or 23S17. It is a 16-bit I/O expander with serial interface. So it features 16-bit remote bidirectional I/O port. Okay, I/O pin set to input as default high speed I2C for the 23071, but mine's 23S71, so it's got a high speed SPI up to 10 megahertz. Okay, it has configurable interrupt for either on change or for pin changes, polarity inversion, operating voltage. So it looks like it'd be good for 3.3 volts like on ESPs, or up to 5 volts on your average Arduino thingy.
Alright, so there's the answer to our question. It is a multiplexer, a 16 port I/O. So if you're running short on digital I/O pins, there's the magic right there. Cool.
MCP23S17 bidirectional 16-bit I/O expander, SPI serial interface shield module. From Alice 110 1983, I paid $2.93 Canadian. So as we saw in the data sheet, this can be either SPI or I2C, but this particular one is the 23S17, the S making it SPI. And pretty much all the same basic information that we were able to pull out of the data sheet earlier.
All right, what else do I have in this same shipment? Oh-ho, oh-ho, oh-ho. Some chips in there, but I've got a batch of non-conductive, allegedly static resistant or anti-static or static proof, whatever, tweezers. And I do have back here a whole assortment of metallic tweezers in nice fine points. I tend to use them for modeling and stuff originally, but more and more I'm finding tweezers come in handy for electronics, especially as I'm playing with more surface mount. So I've got a bunch of different profiles here. At the risk of being accused of knolling, which is forbidden in my shop, as you well know, I'm going to line these guys up and just take a look at the different tip profiles. So we've got that little grabber there, reaching around stuff. This one, a little fine needly point. Let me zoom in a little bit more. A little fine needly point. However, it's not what you'd call a precision device. Can you see that? Unless it got damaged in shipping. That's less than useful. Okay. There's another one. It's not quite as sharp a point, but at least it comes together. That one's got some square jaws that are, how big are they? They are, it's about 4 millimeters across. Another pair of square jaws that are, that's not in focus, is it? That are 5-6 millimeters across, and a wider set, which look like they're also 6 millimeters across. Are they? No, they're a bit wider. All right, so that's kind of neat. They claim to be usable for soldering. I wonder just how high temp they are. Ah! This is the one with the buggered up tips on it, so I'm not too concerned about it. It's getting a little bit closer here. Yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't use those for soldering with, I guess. Although, no, that has deformed them. Oh, yeah. Yeah, okay, so they're not for soldering, but they are, or at least if you're getting in and out quickly, I guess. But they do claim to be anti-static, which means I wonder if they're resistive. No, they're not. Okay, so they're not conductive. Non-conductive's okay if you're working in a live circuitry. I can get along with that. Okay, so a set of non-conductive tweezers.
7 pieces anti-static tweezer tools. Straight bend plastic, heat resistant. I would challenge that heat resistance statement given the evidence that we saw earlier. However, anti-static, probably. Plastic, definitely. From LS110 1983 again, $1.40 Canadian for the set of 7 of them.
There was something else in that shrink, wasn't there? In that, yeah. Couple of chips whose labels have got stuck to the bubbles. That's not a part number. Well, it's a, it is a part number. Oh. Okay. That's the dip version of this guy. It's exactly the same chip, just as a dip. Okay.
And here is two pieces MCP23S17E IC IO expander SPI 16B, 16 bits, I guess. 28-pin SDIP new. All the same parameters and everything as the board, only minus the board. It's just a bare chip. So that was again from Alice 111-1883 for $2.77 Canadian for a pair of them. Not much else to see down here other than the same information.
Okay, what do you think? A couple more things? This one says LED 1. Oh, that's a lot more than one LED. That's a whole bunch of LEDs. What do we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 by 4, 50 LED modules on boards. Ooh, data in, data out. Those are what Adafruit calls NeoPixels, and what people who don't want to get sued called WS2812. I have some more of them over here, which I've had for a while. What those guys are, if you haven't seen them before, they're a three-color LED and a Wii control chip, all in one package. A couple of resistors just because you need resistors. And you hook them up like I have them here, actually. So 5 volts and ground are the top and bottom, the bare copper on my little example there. And the white wire running up the middle is data in from the microcontroller over on this side. And then data out to the next one's data in, and then data out and data in and all the way. And you can chain these guys for huge distances. I think 512 comes to mind, but you can probably put more of them on, and you can run multiple serial strings out of your microcontroller. A lot of people use them to create matrices, not unlike that. Each one of these, however, is 8x8, which would be 48. This is 50. So I could create an 8x8 grid of, it'd be huge compared to that, of multicolor LEDs. Typically they're RGB. Some have a white chip in there as well. I don't think these do because they're much more expensive, those ones. But yeah, so you can create all kinds of interesting color display, multicolor displays and stuff with those. Neat.
Another one I couldn't find the listing for, so here we are back in my history again. Ordered back on June 3rd, which is probably why I can't find the listing. 50 pieces WS2812B IC, 10 millimeters by 3, that's the board itself. The chip is an SMD5050, RGB addressable, board bead chips, 5 volt, random language, $5.70 for 50 of them. From Jian Zhao, 1984.
For those of you who haven't actually seen those WS2812 LEDs in action, here's the little strip that I've got. This is just, as usual, a demo sketch because I suck at programming. So you can, with three wires, one of them being power, one of them being ground, so one wire basically data, you can make these things do any kind of things. You can talk to each one individually, make them do any other RGB goodness at any brightness, and do all kinds of weird patterning and stuff. Okay, last one. This one took forever. It's got the shipping date on there. It took from May until October to get here from China. May, June, July, August, September, October. 6 bloody months to get here. Better be good. Solidly packaged orange tools. Oh, Not electronics tools, though. Lock picks. No doubt the cheapest set I could find, because I wasn't sure whether customs would let them through the border, which they apparently have eventually. Cool. So what do we got here? So there's two tensioning tools. Z-shaped one and L-shaped one. Those are for putting a twist on the lock. Now, this is yet another hobby that I've dabbled in a little bit. A while back, I built my own set of lock picks, which were shoddy and horrible. And I figured, oh, okay, this is kind of fun to play with. So I ordered some. Let's see now. It's definitely magnetic, so it's not high quality stainless steel. Yeah, that's interesting. So what do we got here? 9 of them? 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. Yeah. So there's... Let me zoom in a little bit here on these guys. So what do we got? Some slightly different hooks. A bunch of hooks, actually. A kind of a... little bumpy one. You can use it as a hook, but I think it's really meant to be a sort of a reiki kind of for bouncing around. And I think the professionals would call that a half diamond, which is mutilated or they're not really very good. But these hooks all have a different amount of bend on them.
Back in my history again, because those things disappeared. Ordered in May. That's almost half a year ago now. Not quite. Anyway, $4.42 for 11 pieces. Pack, set, small, unlocking, lock picking, practiced tools, locksmith. Wow, random language. From Keep 2012 Going. And yeah, as I said, The listing's long gone, but if you search for lockpick or lock tools or locksmith tools, you'll find all kinds of them. Although this was, of course, the absolute cheapest that I could find at the time.
And there's today's mailbag. It's a wide variety of stuff. I like this. I ordered these things over like a 6-month period, and they slowly trickle in. And it's like Christmas every month. It's awesome. Thanks for watching. If you've got any questions about any of this stuff or any of the other stuff, or if there's stuff that you'd like to see me order and open 6 months later, hit the comments. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.